In this video, we'll study about the pretracheal fascia. The name itself indicates it lies in front of the trachea. Now we'll see the horizontal extent. So this fascia arises under cover of the sternocleidomastoid muscle. Then it passes medially, forming the anterior wall of the carotid sheath. Then it splits into two layers and encloses the thyroid gland. So this is the thyroid gland. It encloses the thyroid gland and passes in front of the trachea and becomes continuous with the opposite side similar fascia. The anterior layer is thick, whereas the posterior layer of the which covers the thyroid gland is very thin. Hence, any swelling of the thyroid gland tends to enlarge posteriorly and causes compression of the esophagus, producing dysphagia. So now we'll see the vertical extent of the pretracheal fascia. Traced above, the pretracheal fascia is attached to the hyoid bone and in the midline and to the oblique line of the thyroid cartilage and the cricoid cartilage, arch of the cricoid cartilage. The attachment of the pretracheal fascia to the hyoid bone, thyroid cartilage and the cricoid cartilage allows the thyroid gland to move up and down with deglutition. Traced below the fascia, so this is the vertical extent. So above it is attached to the hyoid bone, so it descends down and covering the thyroid gland and descends down below, and the fascia enters the thorax in front of the trachea and the inferior thyroid vein and blends with the apex of the fibrous pericardium. At the thoracic inlet, it also continues with the suprapleural membrane or the Simpson's fascia. So because of its extent to the fibrous pericardium, so any infection in front of the pretracheal fascia may bulge into the suprasternal space or it extends down into the anterior mediastinum. So a fibrous band that is known as the ligament of Berry that is derived from the posterior layer which covers the posterior surface of the thyroid gland, and this connects the lobe of the thyroid gland with the cricoid cartilage. So this ligament of Berry forms a suspensory ligament and helps the thyroid gland to be in position and it do not let it sink into the mediastinum.